This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how product costs flow through accounts using a process costing system. First of all, product costs are tracked by department using a process costing system rather than by job. So if we have multiple departments, and we're going to be using this example, for example, having an assembly department and a finishing department, then we track costs for each of those departments. And when I say costs, I mean product costs, direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead. We're going to be using an example that comes right from the book that relates to a company that produces identical desks. So we've got two departments. Imagine one department that assembles those desks. They have all the different parts that go into the desk and they assemble it. And then we have a department that finishes the desk. Maybe they paint it or stain it and clean it up. That would be part of the finishing department. So we're going to use these two different departments as we go through and talk about how process costing system works. We'll start by talking about how direct material costs are recorded on the books for each production department. So when we, as a production department, pull direct materials out of the raw materials warehouse, we need to record that on the books. And so what you see here with this journal entry is the recording of pulling out raw materials inventory for the assembly department, in which case we add the direct materials to work in process in the assembly department, and we take those direct materials out of the raw materials inventory account. We do the same thing below by showing that if finishing is the one, I'm going to separate these two. If the finishing department is pulling raw materials out of, or direct materials out of the raw materials warehouse, that we would have to make an entry on the books that increases work in process in the finishing department and decreases the raw materials inventory. So you'll notice, again, that we have different work in process inventory accounts that are used to track production costs, one for each department. Next, we look at direct labor costs and how those are recorded on the books, and you're going to see some similarities with direct materials in that when we have our workforce, direct labor workforce, work within a production department, that the cost of that labor will be added to work in process. I'm just putting a plus sign here to show that debiting work in process means to increase it. We're going to add those costs to work in process for the assembly department and then credit in this case, wages payable. We're adding it to wages payable. If we paid cash right away, we'd credit cash, which reduces cash. Again, I'll break these two up. If we have a separate department, say the finishing department, that also has direct labor costs that they incur, we would increase work in process inventory for those direct labor costs and also increase wages payable for those direct labor costs. Lastly, we'll look at the third production cost, and that's manufacturing overhead costs, and how we record those in each production department. So again, similar to direct materials and direct labor, as each department, each production department incurs overhead costs, or another way to put it, depending on the system that's being used, as overhead costs are being applied to each of those production departments, we're going to make an entry that looks like this down here, where we will increase work in process inventory for the assembly department for the manufacturing overhead costs that are incurred by that department. And then we would increase, second entry here, keeping these separate. In the finishing department, we would increase work in process inventory for the manufacturing overhead costs incurred there as well. Notice I don't put a minus sign or a plus sign next to manufacturing overhead. That's a clearing account. We talk about that in a separate chapter, so I'm just going to leave that alone for now, but I won't put a plus or minus sign next to either of those. The important part of this conversation is that we are increasing work in process inventory for the overhead costs that are being incurred for each production department. As soon as the products are completed, we have to move the product costs, direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead costs that are in work in process inventory related to those products that are being finished, completed, over into finished goods inventory. So we're going to add those costs to finished goods inventory and take those costs away from work in process inventory. And here we're looking at the finishing department because that would be the last department that would be working on the desks that we're working on. And as they are completed, those costs get moved over into finished goods inventory. Lastly, when we sell the goods, the cost of the goods that we sell come out of finished goods inventory. So I put a minus sign there. We're crediting finished goods inventory. And those costs are added to cost of goods sold. So that's what the journal entry looks like when we actually sell the goods. Remember, this is not the price that we sell the goods for. It's the cost of the goods that we have sold. The sales price is recorded in a separate entry. Here's a summary of the flow of costs through each of our production departments. Again, assuming that we have an assembly department, and we start with that, this is sequential, and a finishing production department. Remember that we have direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead for each department. And as those costs are incurred, they are debited. We just went through the series of entries that relate to this. Those costs are debited to each production department. And then as those products move from assembly over into finishing, all of those costs related to those products that are being moved get added to the finishing production department. And then the finishing production department incurs additional direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead costs as that department goes through the finishing process. Once those units are completed, those costs get moved to finished goods inventory. And then once those goods are sold, the costs related to the goods that are sold are moved over to cost of goods sold. So this is a summary of how costs flow through a typical process costing system.